these are two stages. One is thought and second is a fruit. And in between in normalcy, there is a mechanism known as execution. It may be mechanical, it may be scientific, it may be technical execution, and it may be the joint execution of various people, it may be a self-motivated execution. So that is the difference between these and these. Those who are in need of a process in between thought and fruit, they are known as baddhas. Those who do not require a process of execution in between the thought and fruit, they are known as siddhas. It is the difference between siddha and baddhas. This is the philosophy that describes this paradigm. The second is the power of faith or belief, deep-rooted belief. Somebody used to say that mere faith is powerful, mere faith is useless. Faith blended with truth. If a person with a deep-rooted faith is taking cyanide to be elixir, it is not going to save the person. It must be having some truth. If you are faithless with the truth, and if your faith is truthless, both of them will not bring the desired result. So that is the faith of belief, that is in religion. Then the power of will, commitment, mental sturdity. We used to see it even in non-religious. There is nothing known as non-religious. Everything is religious and everything is divine. Whether that is latent or obvious, it is a question. We used to say only the persons, those who worship God, they can have the nature revealed, because nature is the painting of God. It is the work of God. It is the skill of God. So if a person is an atheist, how he can become a scientist? It is possible because of two reasons. Persons accepting God in a different dimension, they are also thieves. I don't accept a God that is in a temple, but I accept a God, I accept the truth, eternity, purity, etc. That is conceptive acceptance of divinity. And second thing, even if a person does not accept or care about these things, the janmantara asthitya, a person's time immemorial divinity or divine ordinance or subjection in his history, births and its continuity will reveal the nature. So even atheistic scientists, they have their scientific innovations made fruitful by their Esther millennia or Esther birth divinity and divine practices output, without which they could not have done that. It is the definition, reconciliation that has been given in the scriptures. So paranormalcy, it starts with the power of thought, the power of will. If you just think, that is thought. If you just make a deeper thought, that is known as will. If you just cling to somebody or something, it is something known as objective surrender. If you catch hold of something, that is faith. If you catch hold of something for benefit, that is known as a will. And if you just think, thinking is what we call it, the threshold of mind. Thought process is the spark of mind. And the spark of mind becomes rooted when it becomes faith. When it becomes more potentialized, it becomes will. So in the hierarchy, in the ascending order, thought is the starting point. The thought becomes deep rooted when it becomes faith. Faith becomes potentialized or liberated when it becomes will. These three things are power. For greater persons, even thought is powerful. For mediocre persons, their faith is powerful. The will is powerful for normal people with a sturdy or strong commitment. So this is how we have to study these three major powers. And the problem is, now we have to understand four major steps. If there is such a power, number one, first question is very simple. Does power exist? We are seeing a lot of things. We have seen even the power soap, which is very famous. And there are a lot of products in the name of power. Does power exist means, we know gravity, we know electromagnetic flux, we know lot of other powers like atomic power, hydraulic power, thermal power, electricity, lot of these powers and their various utility services we are enjoying. Apart from this, is there any power which is worthy of not application, reapplication, but by prayer, by worship, by invocation, by ritualization, by realization, is there some sentient power? All of these powerful elements are insentient. Is there any power? That is existence. Number two, even if let some power exist, whether that power is materializable or not, I want something. Can I get something through power? Is it accessible and materializable? That is the second question. Third thing is, even if somebody possesses power and materialization, is it subjected to transmission? Is it transmittable to somebody else? So the existence of power, the transmission possibility of power, between which the materialization policy of power, they are all subject to skepticism. then how to understand that power and how to gain that power, how to apply that power, how to restore that power, these things are the normal questions. Whenever you are conducting any seminar for any person, these things are there. Is the subject matter apprehendable? Whether it is applicable or not for us? Can we access it? Or even at the time of its depletion, whether it is restorable or not? So all of these things are there. Sir, I am purchasing a product. If I just spend it, where can I get it back? Where can I purchase and stock it? These things are very normal in even commodity purchase. So we want to get the real idea of understanding the manufacturer, the distributor, the stockist, and the agencies of the power of paranormal phenomena. This paranormal phenomena, just let me give some exemplifications of paranormal phenomena. Number one is psychokinesis. Just know they have read. Psychokinesis is action, activation, and acceleration of mechanisms by thought. Sankalpa matrena, yantrana manushyanancha, akarana karana anyatha karana samarthata ujjate. So, technology of consciousness is a project that has been taken by Dr. Shraddharu Ranade of Pondicherry Aurobindo University, by which like auto writing, how to make a pen write, and how to make a typewriter automatically type, and how to make a mechanism either to act or to activate or to be accelerated. If it is doing 100 words per minute, it will do 500 words per minute. So, increasing the potentiality into 5 times, multiplicity, upgradation, more precision. So this thing is known as psychokinesis. Then second thing is insta assimilation. Immediately assimilating anything. For example, if there are 500 pages of book, to just copy inside a CD, it will not take the same time which is being taken for you to read and to assimilate. Likewise, intra assimilation and insta assimilation, extra assimilation and exo assimilation. To take something to your deepest mind and to have this known as adhita smara, it is known as intra assimilation. Inter assimilation is just squeezing, just as you are getting from somebody some coconut or fruit or garland, just to squeeze up the knowledge of a person and take a copy inside your mind, just to download the message or the memory of an external brain of a capable person and to upload the same thing inside your brain is known as inter-assimilation. Exo-assimilation is from a library, from stored family scripts, from museum, everything etc. Immediately get those pages or get those necessary elements, immediately copy them and reproduce. This may be even transient or permanent. If you don't want to hold all of these things, you will keep it in bubble memory. If you want to keep it for eternity for propagation, that will be in your perennial or permanent memory. So these are the various cases. Then interpenetration and intrapenetration and exopenetration, parapenetration. We know that we are made up of hard matter and we are hindered by these type of obstacles like this wall, this glass, various things are there. So to cross those things, that is known as parapenetration. We can enter into any body. We can cross any hindrance or obstacle and we can deeply enter into any more person or we can hold any person's internal structure inside us. These things are very great skills which have been told in the Shastras. Intrapenetration, interpenetration, parapenetration, intra-assimilation, inter-assimilation, psychokinesis, pervasion, simultaneous presence in various places. So it is a special physics, paraparticle physics. When I am telling about these type of things to physician and physicist. The physicist deals with the rules of physics and physician deals with the rules of the physical body and understanding the bodily movements. Then generally I told that there are two things in science. One is grade and second thing is discipline. Everything is in science, but there is a difference in grade and discipline. For example, if I want to know about, for example, some law, that is Fleming's rule, then I must go into physics. If I see the search or try to see the same in mathematics, I cannot get it. That is also a science. If I want to see that in biology, I cannot get that. If I want to see the function of your heart in physics, I cannot get it because of the discipline variation. And grade variation, if I want to understand, for example, integral calculus or differential calculus, I cannot get it.